Okay, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Ulysses with Driven Spec, and we got another video that's going to be going on today. I just got a different mod for the car. I'm not sure if you guys heard of it. It's called, Ghost Shadow Lighting or something like that. This would typically be it. Now, what I do have is a Firebird logo, of course, for the Firebird. But I am going to be running into one issue that I kind of want to try and go over with you guys, because I haven't seen a video on YouTube yet. So this little thing here is basically gonna go as kind of like a courtesy light, but it will be going under for the Firebird. But my problem with the Firebird is, hold on, let me get the keys. Strong keys, okay. Oh. The Firebird does not have one. So, I'm going to have to be trying to figure out what I'm going to wire this to, so that every time I open the door, this here light comes on like these. So, I'm thinking I might have to buy another wire to go and be able to connect this, and maybe I can run it up to here. Because I don't think there's anything in the door that activates when the door opens, besides me pushing the unlock button. Okay, guys, so I got the door off. A couple things I had to do. It has quite a couple of these little clips here, and I'm not sure if I really should call them clips, but there's quite a couple of them. There's a couple things you want to do before you try and get this off, because it's easier to kind of somewhat lift it up. If you pull on it, there's a chance of you breaking these and your door not going back on properly, because these go inside each one of these little holes and it kind of tucks down on it. But try and lift this back up some. I might have to get this door panel replaced, because I do not like that. But okay, the door is going to sit up like this here, and what you're going to have to do is, there's a screw there. There's another one that's up under here. I'm not sure if you can really see that. There's another one that's gonna go right here. And where this here part goes for the handle, there will be one there. So you're gonna wanna take this off. This here, you can kinda, I guess, take like a flathead screwdriver, pop it up, and I couldn't manage to get this one out. I don't know why I tried pulling this piece here up and pulling that out. It doesn't want to come out. I don't want to break it. So I'm just going to leave it. I can work with it there. But I went ahead and I pulled the other two pieces like this here out, so I can kind of get it somewhat out of the way. But after you do all that, all you do is just kind of somewhat lift it up a little bit, and it should begin to pop out of place. You're going to want to unplug this part here, goes to the tweeter if you do have the Monsoon speakers and radio system. I didn't worry about this one here. It's not in the way. I don't need to unplug it, so I'm gonna leave it. Okay, so my hole has been drilled. I did it from under so that I have a smooth surface sitting here, because the other side, like I said, it has both of these pieces here. One to set it in place, and this other one will basically lock it into place. So from the inside, I would actually have to feed the wire through the bottom into the inside, and then pull this here up. So I'll be having to take both of these here off, like so. That's one. And there's two. Now that both of those are off, let's see if I can get this to sit right. It's a wide angle lens, so I think it should be fine. And then feed my wires up. And then okay, it seems like I'm gonna have to probably, oh, never mind. Nah. Okay. I'm gonna have to I guess, drill this a little bit more, get a little more open so I don't mess up the threading. But just like so, feed that through, this part goes in, and then re-screw those screws, put them back through here, re-screw them, tighten it down, tighten the bottom one first, and then tighten the top one to keep that one into place. And okay guys, so I went, bought some wire. Unfortunately, I couldn't find any that had two different colors. So I just went ahead, I stuck with the red one instead of, I didn't really feel like buying two different ones. So I went with the red, and what I'll do is I'll probably use a black Sharpie to tell the difference between your positive, your negative. But what I did from here is, okay, I kind of over-linked this purposely. This is kind of hard without having anywhere to put this GoPro right now. But from here, basically, and then I got it to where it measures out to over here, kind of. I'm thinking about making a small incision here, probably, and seeing if I can get it to run through there, and then just save myself a lot of time and trouble, kind of run it up through here and up here to one of these parts here. But the reason why I kind of cut it down here, knowing that this wire got a okay reach to about here, is because I'm gonna need some open space, so when the door opens, closes, it's not pulling this and pulling the wire out of place. So that's why I did that. But I'm gonna go ahead and cut one more piece this exact same length, touch it up with a Sharpie, and then I'm gonna wire it. Well, I'll probably drill a hole and run them through there and then have them run this way. That'll probably be so much more easier. So I might have to take this here speaker out in order to do so. We'll see. But I'll probably do that and just go from there. Alright guys, here's the end result. I wish it was a little bit brighter, I would say. It is still nice. I think it would probably actually be a little bit lighter if I didn't have this here spotlight here. But this is the end result. Like I said, I just brought the wiring. Where's my flashlight? I also changed these little terminals. They start to go bad on your car. I would suggest changing them before you can't get them off. So I changed both of those. They're only like $2 at Walmart. Okay. So the light is drilled in here. As you can see, there's a bunch of wires still. Same as here. So what I'm going to do, and I completely forgot to unplug the battery before I did this, so I shorted out a fuse. Lucky I had another one. But yeah, so I drilled this small little hole there, enough to put one through, and then I forced the other through, so it's not like really just damaging it too much. But yeah, so I ran this here, and what I was going to do is kind of tuck some of this here, but I'm going to pull a little bit to where when the door opens, it's not tugging the wire and completely messing this up. But I ran it here. And I had to figure out these wires between the actual negative and a positive wire. So that blue and white one would be, hold on. Sorry about that. So the blue and white one would be your positive. The black one, of course, is negative. So I'm not exactly sure what the white one is. But you don't need it, so I wouldn't even mess with it. But always make sure that you unplug the battery, because like I said, I shorted out a fuse. Lucky I didn't shock myself. But yeah, that's what I did. I'm gonna go ahead, tape those up, and do the other side. But the other side will of course be different, because the wire here only runs this way. Went ahead and went up the other A pillar, so reach up here. Kind of did the same there, And I'm going to be trying to tuck this here under the A-pillar there and come across, brought it up here. So it's just going to run all the way across here. And I just went ahead and lined it back up with these here wires. So just like so. I figured that would be so much more easier than trying to run it under there and all that and doing this here. I still got to go back and try and hide this as good as I can. But that's what I did. It's quite a bit darker. We'll see if it'll show a little bit brighter. I'm going to get this all put back together and show you guys the overall look of it. Okay, guys, this actually happened at perfect timing. Okay, the courtesy lights just turned off on their own. So it means that they do only operate. I can hate them bugs. They do only operate when those lights are on, so they're not constantly running. If I click the unlock button, as you can see, there it goes. Show you the other side. That's a bit in the grass. Let's see. But there it goes. Like I said, I wish it was a little brighter. Kind of like, if it lit up more like that, being this far down, that would be awesome. But hey, it was only 15 bucks, so who cares? I couldn't really manage to hide this here wire too much. But I'm not going to worry about it. But the rest of it is completely concealed. You can't see it. Like I said, it's going all the way across here to the other side and just tied in with the other wires. But that'll be it for today. And hope you guys liked it. Hope you guys enjoyed. I guess learning something new or been trying to figure something out and somebody's showing you a different way of doing it. But that'll be all for today. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, whatever it is that you want to do. Catch you guys later.